was AFCON Blades.
What an amazing moment to be alive. It's another AFCON, the 34th edition, taking place at Ivory Coast.
As Nigerians celebrate their team's first AFCON final qualification since 2013, having defeated the Bafana Bafana of South Africa in the semi-final, Tariq Sports highlights seven facts that emerged following Nigeria's qualification for the final.
Push pause, no, I push play. I won't stop till I make a change.
Number one, Samuel Chukwueze was an effective substitute. The Inter forward took on two Bafana Bafana defenders, thus putting pressure on Mbala, who brought down Victor Osimhen in the area. That was resulting in a penalty kick, which was combated by Trost Ekong and gave Nigeria the needed lead. Number two, Teremofi takes up the most difficult task. He had just 10 minutes on his AFCON debut, yet had two important impacts. Mofi doused penalty kick tension against Bafana Bafana Rowan Williams. Mofi took Nigeria's first spot kick and combated perfectly through the middle, leaving Rowan Williams with no chance. His goal gave all the Super Eagles penalty takers the confidence to go forward and score. Number three, Tebeso replayed the Jokers against Ugo Bros. It was a tactical game of defenses, and certainly fans weren't disappointed as both teams could only break their clean sheets run via spot kicks. Nigeria took the lead via Trost Ekong 67 minutes to end Bafana Bafana's clean sheet run. And Mokwena's 19 minutes goal from the spot kick also ended Super Eagles' clean sheet run. But that wasn't the deal. That only showed that both teams matched tactics and with tactics. In fact, they both adopted 4-3-3 formation. The real joker played by Pesero was a spot kick takers. The Portuguese tactician's decision to substitute Alex Iwobi, Ademola Lookman, Victor Osimhen, and Frank Onyeka would have been questioned by many. Aside from the coaching crew, Pesero brought in Chukwueze, Murphy, Yusuf Obiru, and Ihinacho, unknown to many that he was bringing in his best spot kick takers. Hugo Bruce and his team would have analyzed the likes of Osimhen, Lookman, Iwobi, and other regular players. Unfortunately, for the Bafana Bafana, experienced players like Omeru, Murphy, and Ihinacho, who had never played a game until Wednesday evening, weren't considered in the analysis. And that made it difficult for Rowan Williams, who saved a penalty earlier in the quarterfinals, to be able to save any off the Super Eagles spot kick. Number four, Nwabili outshines Rowan, Nigeria's first choice goalkeeper at the ongoing AFCON in Ivory Coast. Stanley Nwabili was the hero in the Super Eagles victory against South Africa in the first semi-final played on Wednesday at Stade Bouaké. Before the game, eyes were on Rowan Williams, the Bafana Bafana goalkeeper and captain, who had saved four penalty kicks in South Africa's final match against Cape Verde. In a twist of events, it was Nwabili, Nigeria's goalkeeper, who saved two spot kicks, and Williams couldn't stop any of Nigeria's five spot kicks. The kick missed by Ola Aina would have been a goal because Rowan had gone the wrong way, but the corner ball had too much power on it, and over the bar it went. Number five, Super Eagles break jeans of Golden Bros. Progressing into the final of the 2023 African Cup of Nations means the decade of Golden Bros has finally been broken by the Super Eagles. Nigeria have now played a record 16 semi-final at the African Cup of Nations for Wednesday victory. They've only progressed from one of their last six at this stage of the competition, going on to win the competition in South Africa in 2013. A decade later, Nigeria broke that jeans and made it another AFCON final, and certainly won't be bronze this time. Number six, Osimhen has only scored one goal despite attempting the most shots. He has 24 at the 2023 AFCON Cup of Nations, a shot conversion rate of 4% with an expected goal tally of 3. He is underperforming his expected goal by a bigger margin than any other player. That's -2 for him. Nigeria's Victor Osimhen has had 24 shots at the 2023 African Cup of Nations, although he has only managed one goal, that is 4% conversion rate since 2010. Osimhen has had 4 goals overturned in this tournament, first against Equatorial Guinea, against Cote d'Ivoire in the group stage, and another against Angola and South Africa in the quarterfinal and semi-final respectively. Number 7, Super Eagles qualify for their 8th AFCON final. Nigeria are playing in their 8th AFCON final. Only Egypt and Ghana, who have played 9 finals each, have played in most such games in the competition, excluding final groups. The Super Eagles have been victorious in 2 of their last 3, in 1994 and in 2013. They lost on penalties in 2000, having lost their 3 beforehand. That was in 1984, 1988, and 1990. And that's it, guys. 7 facts emerging from Nigeria's victory over South Africa at the African Cup of
AFCON Blades.